It is a product said to have taken 9 months to be finally unveiled. The temperatures in the party headquarters signaling that all was ready for the highly publicized Jubilee major launch. Over 10,000 delegates are set to arrive in the city tomorrow to grace the occasion that is said to be of pomp and color. Early in the morning, TNA delegates were seen arriving at the TNA headquarters to attend the three-day event. Prados branded in Jubilee colors were paraded outside the building, set to be used during the launch period. Speaking at the Tuku Pamoja Towers, the interim steering committee led by Senator Kiraitu Murungi and Noah Wekesa affirmed that the objective of the merger was to create a large political outfit, presumably with a wide national following, and not an intention to kill democracy.
We are not killing democracy. There are 62 political parties in Kenya, and only 14 of us have come together to form a national party. So we are within ourselves, we are going to be free.
Coalition for Reforms and Democracy Code has raised concern over the amount of money set to be used by the Jubilee during their party launch this weekend.
This is a unique party in the history of all parties in Kenya, concerning that it has tried to unite the country, bringing like 12 parties that ago into one to form one party. That alone can tell you the generational thinking and change of a change in transition when it comes to political leadership of the country. The dignity of being a Kenyan now when we are united is a plus even to the generation that are coming. And as young people in this country, when we see this preaching of unity, this coming together, it really heals our heart, because we all know that many young people this day, even they cannot even speak their own mother tongue language. We have counties. We go hustling in different counties. We go look for job opportunities, and we get our salaries. We get we earn our living not in from our local county or local community, but across the counties. The selling point of Jubilee is the unity. Young people in this country, we are not happy when we see our leaders divided. But we gain more when they are united. As the elders are planning their own, we are also negotiating for the young people to have their space. But whoever is going to come to that space, whether old or young, should have an agenda to drive this country ahead. We don't need leaders because of having leaders.
The Interim National Steering Committee further argued that the Interim National Executive Committee officials will be selected on a certain created formula in a free and fair manner. Hence, it should not be a contentious matter in the party.
After the party is launched, that the president and the deputy president, using a formula which we have developed, are going to look at the officials, they are going to look at Kenyans, and they are going to nominate the first interim officials of this party.
Delegates from all the 13 parties are tomorrow expected to meet in Bomas of Kenya and Kasarani Stadium for the launch. With political temperatures rising 11 months to the next general election and all system go for the Jubilee Party, it is without a doubt that the showdown for the next general election will be a fierce battle. Irene Mwangi, KUTV, Nairobi.